So I have this junk pieces of wood put together, 2x4s put together to hold my Lincoln welder as a welding cart. So I'm going to build a new welding cart today, and I'm going to do it out of the angle iron that came, that was wrapped around my bike, the dirt bike that I bought. So let's do this. I have to put some boards under here to level it out, level the cart out. Yeah, one of these days I'll build myself a welding table. What I'm going to do here is I know a lot of carts, they have like a chain to help the bottle from not moving. But I'm not, there's no point in me putting a chain. What I'm going to do is I'm going to box it in. It'll stay nice and sturdy, and whenever I want to take it out, I just lift it up. I got to lift it up anyway to take it to the car to get it refilled, so. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a support here. This is a little flimsy. It'll be okay, but I'm just going to put a support. Okay, I got the bottle mount on. I don't have to tie the bottle up with anything. It'll just slide right in here. I see some carts, they have the handle back here where the bottle is. I'm not going to do that. I'm actually going to put my handle on the front. This way, where the front is, where I need to weld it, to weld, I can just move the cart this way or that way, because the wheels, the swivel wheels are going to be on the front. And the solid ones are going to be on the back. And this way I can just move the cart this way back and forth. Sounds good? Cool.
Power.
I didn't have one straight pipe for the handle. So I welded three pieces together to make it long enough. That's okay though. The whole cart is made out of scrap anyway, so. It'll still come out nice. So I went ahead and I painted the handle so it can dry, because the rest I'm going to paint black, except for the shelves. And this way, when I go to paint the rest of the cart, I can take this off. Cool? Cool.
Thank you.
miles an hour.
I might end up putting a little wedge in here. Yeah, I think I might put a little wedge in here.
Perfect flavor of pumpkin spice. We have just the thing.
Introducing Tim Horton's very own pumpkin spice latte.
Matt Power.
We took our handcrafted lattes made with Arabica espresso beans.
Cool.
Steamed 100% Canadian milk.
Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you all guys on my next video.
Available now for a limited time at a price you'll fall for. The Nissan Redline Clio is back. Clio's